Okay, here we are again. I want to show you a few things. Here's Lucy here, laying down, okay? She looks far different than the other dogs. The other dogs are big and black. There's one over there and one over there. There's Chloe the cat.
We have another cat here also.
Guys, hey, that's enough. Excuse me. Excuse me. All right, that's enough. Settle down. Lucy, go back. Go back, Lucy. All right, guys, settle down. Everyone sit, please. That's enough. Everyone sit. Sit. Come on. That's enough. Settle down. That's enough. All right, just relax. Hey. That's enough. Shush. All right, we're going back into the other room. Come on. Here we go. Back into the other room. So this works better, as you can see. Just moving him out of the area. All right, that's enough. Everyone sit, please. Everyone sit. Come on, sit. Sit. That's good. Relax. Everything's fine, guys. Everything's fine. You wait here now. Wait here. I'm holding up one finger, and I'm telling them to wait. Wait, guys. Wait. I'm going to go look out the door. Okay. Everything's fine. Bob, that's enough. Okay, thank you. Okay, so now, as you can see, that's what I did. Now, let me explain this. If you have a problem like this with your dog, and you do this every time that they bark and go crazy when there's a noise, if you do this every time, they will learn that it's okay, everything's calm, everything's okay. Now, I don't know if you noticed, but all this time, Lucy did get up and look with the other dogs because she's a pack animal and she's following along just like everyone else. But she did not emit one noise, not one. She's as curious as everyone else, but not one bark came out of her. Okay? Now, the dogs here are relaxed and calm, as you can see, and all it was me being assertive. I was calm and relaxed, and so they became calm and relaxed. If I stayed at the door, now what I did was when I first started, I stayed at the door, and the dogs just couldn't seem to calm down. So what did I do? I went and I got, I pushed to move the dogs by walking them backwards into the living room here, where they were able to sit and calm down. And now they are just completely relaxing. This is Lukey here. He's an older dog. He's the oldest one here. Probably the leader of all the barkers. And he's laying down now just as calm as can be. So this is how it's done. Assertiveness is really important. Now, let's talk about some other forms of being assertive. Let's say you call your dog to come to you and they don't come. Well, you should do the same thing in a way. You're still assertive, you're not screaming and yelling, but what you do is you get your leash and you go to them. Leash them up and bring them in, or bring them to you, and do it that way. Just be creative, and again, as I say with all my classes, if you ever want to talk to me, feel free, call me, email me, we'll have a conversation, and I'll talk you through the training that I do. Look at this. It's just wonderful. And actually, that was not a bad scene compared to what I've heard in the past. It's amazing that these dogs have actually become so calm. And I actually have not. As I said, this is not, these are not really clients. These are friends. I'm staying here for a time. Since I moved down here to North Carolina, and I'm simply just being myself, and the dogs have calmed down quite a bit, and so this is good stuff. So let's say you live in an apartment and your dogs are freaking out every time that somebody walks by. Well, I can bet that your neighbors don't like it very much. And what I recommend is that you do this. It's very simple. So you're learning here. This is assertiveness training. It is very simple stuff. Stay calm, cool, collected. Keep your voice at a low level. Do not punish your animals. Do not scream at them. Keep in control and simply be assertive. Be assertive. Be consistent. Be the pack leader with your dog.